Welcome to Organ India's podcast, New Beginnings, where we bring to life stories of experiences faced by organ donors and recipients to bring awareness about organ donation. In today's episode, we have Mr. Amit Dua, a man who's received a heart transplant. To give our listeners a brief, Amit was born with a congenital heart disease. His parents came to know about this when he was just 3 months old. Till the age of graduation, he was on medication for his condition. Eager to find a solution to his condition, he came across an operation that would be conducted in AIIMS, which could fix his condition. He went through with the operation. However, 15-16 years after the operation, the effects of the operation started to wear off, and the complications started to come back, and he was advised by the doctors to opt for a heart transplant. Shocked at first, he went through with the idea and enrolled himself for the transplant list. Today, Mr. Dua will share with us his personal experience with receiving a heart transplant. So without wasting any more time, I'll let Mr. Dua talk for himself. Welcome, Mr. Dua.
Thank you very much for having me. Yeah. Well, I am born and brought up in Delhi and was lucky enough to have the medical facilities, probably the best in India, and today's time.
Yeah.
At the age of 3 months, just 3 months, my parents got to know that I had a heart disease, and which is popularly called a blue baby syndrome.
Yes.
But on further investigations, it was revealed that the problem was much larger than the blue baby syndrome and had some major complications in the heart. So the surgery was avoided at that time. Otherwise, it could have been conducted at the very younger age and have healed me up much earlier. The problem continued, and we were just on the medications for, let's say, around 20, 21 years. But then it was like getting worse and worse day by day. So we decided to get operated, and was lucky enough to get operated at AIIMS in 2000. As you said, the operation lasted for 15-16 years and started to wear out. There were major complications, and after 15-16 years, I started bleeding from nose. I had bloated stomach and had swelling in all my feet, and it was difficult for me to breathe also. So later on, investigations told that my heart was just working at 16% capacity, and it would be like a bomb taking any time. So the doctors advised me not to go for further operation, because if we do at that time, it may last for just 4-5 years and the problems may come back. Probably it may not be successful also, since the first operation in 2000 was also a very complicated operation, which could not be completed well in time. So they advised me to go for a transplant in Chennai. Probably the doctors advised me it's better to go in Chennai, as they have the best in Fortis Malar at that time, Dr. Balasubramanian.
I'm sure hearing about a heart operation for the first time must have been a really terrifying experience.
Well, at the age of 20, we were mentally prepared because we knew there is no other alternative to surgery. But second time, it was just me and my family of three, my wife and my kid of 4 years old, 3 years old at that time. So digesting that I had to go under transplant was a very difficult thing for me. I got to know that in September 2016, and probably the conditions worsened till the time of till the year end. December 2016, it became like, yes, I need the operation, and it has to be done. It has to be done really fast. The condition was deteriorating day by day. So we consulted the doctor at JP Noida Hospital, which was Dr. Rajesh Sharma, who had been my surgeon earlier also in 2000. So he helped me a lot. Dr. Sharma was kind enough to refer me to Dr. Bala. It was under his guidance that when all my reports were conducted in Delhi and sent to Chennai to Dr. Bala. Then I met Dr. Bala in Jan. He advised me to come over and we will register you for a transplant. And when I spoke to my office about this, they asked me to, firstly they said, okay, we'll let you know, but they asked me to resign after that and come back. They'll see that once I come back, they will see if I can be like taken back or not.
That is not a ideal position to be in. Exactly.
Yes, so that was the most critical part, going for a transplant. Because I think the mental support is much required than anything else, and at that point of time. So right. Once in December 2016, I was without a job. I had to go for a major surgery of my life. I think it was the biggest surgery of my life. Probably everyone who are going through a transplant.
Yeah.
It's not a small surgery where you can go and come out in 5-10 days.
Time.
5-10 days is not a, it's not a matter of 5-10 days that you go and get come out of a hospital.
Correct.
It was a matter of life and death. And that too at an unknown place of Chennai. I was born and brought up. I told you, I am born and brought up in Delhi. My all my places. My, I had a initial education in Delhi. My graduation was in Delhi and post graduation also in Delhi. Going to Chennai and living amongst the unknown people altogether was a difficult thing for me.
I can imagine.
Plus, my wife is also working. She had to take a leave also for the same. She's a government employee, so she had to request for I to make my child leave her education for at least 3 months. Initially, me and my wife went to Chennai for we had hoped that it will work out soon, but as the time passed, they did the further investigations and said I need a heart which is much fitter and younger because of the complications. And certain reports also went against me, like they said once a patient comes, his values for transplant are almost negligible or they are negative.
So what is your first reaction when you heard that you had a match for your heart transplant?
Well, I knew about the procedures that they had to go for. Somebody had guided me, my doctors guided me about the factors involved, and then I studied on the websites also. They need to match the heart best to your age and condition. Since my condition was much complicated and I had a congenital disease and was operated earlier also, so it was a bit not an easy kind of a thing, and doctors knew that they are going to put their hands to something which is really complicated.
But eventually you found a match, and hopefully
it took them about 2.5 months to find a match.
Two and a half months.
It was a long period of
but
85 days.
Especially in India, to find a match, it's very rare, and it's a very because of the lack of awareness about organ donation.
That's right. Especially in the northern India, the awareness is very, very less.
Yes.
I'll say that. In North India, maybe the taboos of our religion or what you say, the myths around about the organ donations are much higher than in the South.
Correct.
Where I believe people are more aware of donating their organs than in the North India.
Yeah, that is a fact also that I can attest to. And the fact that you received a heart transplant shows really the power of donating your organs and what donating your organs can do. So I want the listeners to understand this. You never know who you may end up helping, and the fact that there are many such people out there whose lives can literally be changed by you and your organs is
definitely yes. I believe every person who is born in India, along with their birth certificate, they should be given a certificate to donate the organs also.
Correct.
Unless and until they are really suffering from some rare diseases, they should be given the right to donate their organs.
If a person has the opportunity, they should definitely donate their organs.
I don't believe this is an opportunity. This should be a right. This should be a duty of every citizen or every person who is getting born in India to donate the organs. Because once we are dying, we don't have any control of our organs. Have any control on our organs. We should definitely be donating and helping out those who are suffering.
Correct.
Going to the ashes should help somebody, not be like we are taking our own body to ashes.
Correct, sir. Anyway, sir, to conclude this podcast, Mr. Dua, do you have any message for the people listening regarding organ donation?
Definitely, yes. Probably I'll say everyone to pledge their organs and help out those who are needy. It helps. It really helps. People like me, people like others who are suffering, they need your support. Definitely. Before going to ashes, at least pledge your organs for their support. Thank you.